That's why I don't wear high heels, because I know I don't look comfortable, I don't look effortless, I don't... Some people can walk in it so gracefully, like a gazelle. Me, I look like a clippity-cloppity newborn giraffe. Hey sister, how you doing? Did you know that you're Greetings, greetings. Salam alaikum, namaste, etasem, bawani, and the list goes on. My name is Kai Kamateja and you are here on the Eyeame Channel. Welcome back to our new series of the month, the We Are Beautiful series. A series created to society standards and allow for young girls to know that their phenotype is doused in beauty. So the first video, today has been a complete madness. It's not going how I wanted it to go, but you know, you've got to push through and persevere. So today's video is how to be beautiful and how to find your signature style, a style that is specific and unique to you. So this is what I've been using. Let me just give a little brief background story. Growing up, I thought I was clapped. Growing up, I thought I was ugly. It was like one of my biggest insecurities. And I'm tall, I'm dark skinned, I'm big, and a plethora of other things. And with that, I've had to learn how to manage myself, how to utilize what I do have and bring it to the forefront. So I've accumulated a few things that I think would be important to share. Okay, so we're gonna work from the head down. For the life of me, I've not made any notes about hair, but I've got a video coming up about it, so hold tight. First, let's talk about makeup. For those of us who want to wear makeup or choose to wear makeup, find a feature that is special to you, that can be your eyes, that can be your skin, that can be your facial features, that can be your bone structure, that can be symmetry. Find something that's particularly flattering to you and explore it. So say for example, if you've got really, really nice eyes, try different eyeshadow techniques, try different eyelashes, try different, you can, you know, wear eyeliner underneath, you can wear eyeliner on top, you can do fox eyes. Just play around and see which one suits you best. For me, the way that I do my makeup, I only enhance myself. First of all, I'm not good at makeup. Secondly, my face can't take a lot of makeup, so I just know all I can do is enhance it. I don't think I have any particular one fantastic feature. I quite like the shape of my face. I like how circular it is. But other than that, I don't think there's anything that's like outstanding. So just find makeup that works for you. Also get samples. Oh my gosh, get samples. It will be really, really helpful. Okay, so the next thing is to identify your undertone. Do you have a cool undertone, a warm undertone, a neutral undertone? You can do this by looking at your skin. If you can see a lot of red in your skin, it is most likely that you're cool. If you look also here on your wrist and you see blue veins, it's an indication of coolness. And that's going to determine the type of jewelry and colours that you can wear, but we'll get onto that eventually. Likewise, if you have yellows and oranges, you're more warm. And hair on your wrist, it would mean you have green undertones. And then I don't really know how you identify if you've got neutral undertones. When I was younger, I had cool undertones, and now I would say I have neutral undertones, but I play up the warmth. That's what I personally like. So once you've identified your undertone, we can now extend that and look into colour theory. What colours look best on our skin? So for people that have cool undertones, they look best in whites, greys, blacks, anything that looks like moonlight, blues, cool greens, seafoam, mint. People that have warm undertones, they look good in bronze, in orange, in copper, in yellows. But see, this is where the plot thickens, because yellow, automatically you assume it's a warm colour. But I'm going to show you here. Here is a... Look at my editing skills. Here is a cool toned yellow, and then here is a warm toned yellow. Again, just play around with it. Who knows, you might be a warm toned person that enjoys cool tones. It complements you, it serves you. I think I've mentioned, yes, in reference to jewellery, silver for cool tones, and then gold for warm tones. But FYI, I feel like all dark skin sisters look phenomenal in gold. Do you look like the sun or do you look like the moon? That also can help as well. You know, I've got to bring a little bit of femininity, some nature, some essence. So the fourth thing is to relate to your feminine archetype. I've mentioned it in a video and I'll attach the link below. We all have different energies. Some of us are sirens, some of us are huntresses, some of us are mystics, the mothers, the maidens, the queens. And that will really help you to identify, oh, this is why when I wear leather, it does not look good on me. It doesn't even, the energy's off. Or if I wear, you know, mermaid-tailed dress, it doesn't match up, it doesn't make sense. So that's what I use. It's been so, so helpful. I always mention this, yeah, I use astrology a lot. And I use just my natural personality type. Who are you as a person? Are you a fierce, bold go-getter? Are you a more chilled, cool, you know, bookworm? Whoever you are, that's also going to identify your signature style. And with that comes comfort. Oh my gosh, nothing is worse than seeing a sister wearing clothes and you know that she's uncomfortable. She cannot bend, she cannot twist, she cannot move, she can't do anything. She's just there looking, That's why I don't wear high heels, because I know I don't look comfortable, I don't look effortless, some people can walk in it so gracefully like a gazelle. Me, I look like a clippity-cloppity newborn giraffe. I'm not doing it to myself. So sisters, when you're identifying your signature style, find things that make you feel comfortable, find things that you can, you know, sit and converse and engage in conversation or work or do whatever it is that you're doing and you feel comfortable in those clothes. Those clothes are reflecting who it is that you want to show up as in the world. There are occasions where you might feel comfortable but you don't look comfortable. Something's off about your outfit. So number six for identifying your signature style is finding out your body type. I think there's six body types: apple, hourglass, bell-shaped, upside down triangle, pear. I'm gonna put the diagram here. Look online, you can do a quiz. Alternatively, look in the mirror and identify it for yourself. Where's the broadest, widest part of your body? Where's the smallest part of your body? Are you a tall person? Are you a short person? And that will help to gather what body type you are for you. Based on that, what did I just say? Based on that, you can start to dress for your specific body type. There are countless articles on it, videos on it. You can look on Pinterest and find what clothes will best suit you. Matter of fact, let me mention for me, or what I have learned about my signature so far. So personality wise, I'm quite grounded and I'm a Capricorn, so I wear a lot of browns, a lot of neutrals, tans, camels, as I'm wearing black right now. Occasionally I do wear black and white, but for the most part I feel comfortable wearing warm, bronzy, copper, orange and yellow when it comes to summer, khaki, anything you can find like in earth naturally, in nature, that's what I wear. I do not wear pastels. It doesn't suit me. I don't wear incredibly synthetic colours, like neon colours I don't wear, and I hate purple and red. So actually I'm going to mention, there's a video here earlier on this year, oh my god, the shame. I've got red nails and they are like standing out. So for me, because I'm like calm, the red is too bold, it's too shocking, the nails are wearing me, I am not wearing those nails. And in reference to the clothes that I wear, actually I should mention my body type. I am a very, very big hourglass, and so the highlight for me is how much my waist goes. My waist don't go in that much, but there's a distinct comparison between my waist and my hips. My hips are one of my favorite parts of my body, and so I often highlight that by wearing palazzo pants, or like, so high-waisted palazzo pants, or like a midi bodycon skirt. I wear off-shoulder tops, or I'll wear like a low v-neck. I don't like my arms and I don't like my knees, so for the most part I do wear long sleeve. This is gonna be so embarrassing, I'm putting myself to shame. I'm gonna show a video here of when I tried to make a video with my arms out and I couldn't do it. Alternative clothing stores allows for a uniqueness. It allows me to harness and cultivate a particular signature style. So this can extend to sustainable pieces. Fast fashion is destroying our planet. And so when you go on online boutiques or secondhand shops, charity shops, vintage, it allows for you to have a particular signature style, because it's not just from what's currently out. You can find a piece from the 80s. You can find a piece that was handmade. You never know. You can find a piece from abroad. So that okay, sisters, so there's a few more things. The same way how you are constantly evolving and changing, so will your style. Finding a signature style is reflective of your personality. So the same way I wanted to look when I was 16, I don't want to look like that anymore. Well, in a way, it's evolved. And with that, don't follow fashion. You know, you can incorporate the trends, you can explore them, buy one or two pieces, but don't just be sticking things onto you. Don't just buy because it's in. If it does not fit your body type, your undertones, your personality, Why would you be buying it? That's not because I was supposed to say. Incorporating minimalism into your wardrobe. So a lot of minimalists use a capsule wardrobe whereby they only have crucial essential pieces that are multifunctional and can be worn with a that can be worn in a variety of ways, and it helps to reduce decision fatigue and also helps to ensure that you look good all the time. There was one more thing I was supposed to say. Your signature style is supposed to reflect you. That's it, just you. And so keep you in mind. Please share your tips, your goodness, your juicy advice in the comment section below. And as always, bless up, take care, and remember, Eyeame in everything. Hold on, sis. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Mm-hmm.